Hey everyone, I thought that I had a pretty good storage and backup storage setup considering I have lots of videos to store. After all, I have 6 PoE cameras that record 24/7, and I have loads of video content for this channel. Previously I was storing my active YouTube video projects on my workstation PC before moving them to my 4TB Synology NAS over in the corner there. Every night my NAS would then be backed up to a 1TB Synology C2 backup store. Well, everything other than the CCTV recordings because they were too big. Those remain local right now, albeit they backed on a RAID array, which is not a backup, it's better than nothing of course. But just the video content alone meant I rapidly ran out of disk space a few weeks ago, resulting in my backups being suspended. Since Synology is a bit too expensive for extra backup space, I did some brief research and I purchased 5TB of cheap backup space from iDrive. I then realised my mistake, namely they don't have SFTP or SSH support, and I got a refund 15 minutes later. My bad. Thankfully though, there are loads of other great options for backup space including Microsoft OneDrive. I never thought I'd actually say that, but it's actually a fileable option, weirdly. So here's all the options that I explored and what I ended up choosing for my media content. I firstly checked out both Carbonite and Crashplan, who were previously darlings of the Homelab community, but I noticed something awful on their websites. Shocked me to my core, they offer unlimited backup space. Public service announcement, there is no such thing as unlimited storage. Storage costs money after all, and it's just not possible to store many terabytes of footage for a few pounds or dollars a month. Yes, these plans might work for people with below a terabyte of files to backup, and it is good that they offer full encryption and some good recovery features too, but there's too many stories online of these two companies cancelling people's plans because they used too much of their unlimited storage. So they're clearly not a great option for me because I have lots of files to store. The next options that I explored were the big guys, Dropbox, Google Drive and OneDrive. Dropbox's personal plan isn't too badly priced, offering 2TB of storage for £10 or $10 per month, and they offer lots of other good features, although admittedly many of these aren't available on their basic plan. So Dropbox could have been a good option for lower storage users, but fortunately the prices then ramp up a lot after the basic plan, where you'd essentially be paying £15 or dollars per month for every 3TB of extra storage. This isn't super expensive, but it's not cheap either. 20TB would cost me over £100 per month, for example, and this plan is actually ideally designed for teams, so you'd end up having to create multiple users and then technically having different storage buckets to actually spread your files over, which wouldn't have been great. This is where Google Drive, or Google One, is a lot more competitive, to be honest, with every single plan working out cheaper than with Dropbox. I know there's some big content creators, including Ali Abdal, uses this for some of their storage needs, and I can see why. Google offers some pretty solid features. The main downside for me though is that Google's upload and download speeds are always a bit slow. They certainly didn't max out my 500MB ISP package whenever I use it. Next, I checked out Microsoft OneDrive after seeing people on Reddit mention this as a viable option. I hate being bugged by OneDrive as much as the next person, but their plans aren't bad for lower storage users, costing £6 per month for 1TB of storage. Or for just £2 per month extra, you can get 6TB. Sort of. Basically, some people buy the Microsoft 365 family plan, create 6 users, but then just see this as 6 buckets for the files and store 1TB in each, getting 6TB of fairly cheap backup storage. It's up to you whether you should do this or not though, considering this is actually meant to be a plan for families, but I've heard that it can work quite well. At this point though, I need to mention that SFTP is not really supported by any of these companies by default. What some people do instead though is use a suitable backup service in the middle of their NAS and their chosen backup service provider. Services like CouchDrop and EasyFTP spring to mind for this, although both of these come at an extra cost, especially with CouchDrop, who are really expensive. And so I didn't want to go down this route myself, because otherwise it would have become way too expensive for me. So I started to explore some other options. Since I already had a Synology NAS, I naturally looked at how much it would have cost me to get more than 1TB of C2 backup space, and it's certainly not cheap. Yes, it's super convenient, and has some great enterprise features, including strong encryption, flexible retention policies, and hourly backups, if you want that. But we're almost at Dropbox pricing here, so I quickly ruled that out as an option. I then checked out a few other cloud storage options and started off with Amazon. It can be a bit difficult to actually calculate the exact price they charge for everything, but it seems to almost start at around $25 for 1TB of space, which is very expensive. This is excluding local taxes too, so in the UK we add on 20% value added tax, and it's almost £30 a month for a single terabyte, which is crazy high. 5TB would have cost me £150 per month, which is, yeah. Of course, Amazon do also sell low-priority storage called S3 Glacier, so is that any cheaper? Well, this is even more confusingly priced because it's designed to be slow to retrieve your data, hence the name. But I chose the flexible retrieval plan, which only takes a few minutes to get access to your data. I then chose the average object size as 256 megs, and the pricing fell to around $4 or $5 per month for 1TB, and all the prices are actually quite reasonable across the board, actually. This means that it's a pretty good option, and S3 and Glacier naturally support lots of different file upload methods too. The main downside for me though is I'm a simple man, and I've used AWS a lot with Word previously, and it's not straightforward. There's a fair amount of configuration and setup hoops that you have to jump through before you can use the service. Plus with Glacier, I can't easily just say I want to quickly download these 8 folders and all of the files. So while the pricing was fairly good, I decided to avoid S3 Glacier too. Next up, I explored Backblaze B2, which is quite a popular option for backup space, especially because they were a fraction of the cost of Amazon and other rivals. While they do charge for downloading files, that's only after you use more than 3 times your backup space quota. In other words, if you have 2 terabytes of files, you get 6 terabytes of monthly download bandwidth, which seems reasonable to me. So this starts at just $6 per month in America, however taxes are extra, so in the UK this becomes over £7 per month, and for 5 terabytes of storage I'd be paying £36 per month, which isn't super expensive, but it's not ultra cheap either. The benefit of Backblaze is that you get many of the benefits of Amazon S3 type storage, but at a lower overall cost, plus setting up SFTP isn't too difficult. I then evaluated 2 final backup options, Wasabi and Hetzner. Wasabi are another cloud-based storage platform like Backblaze, and they also claim to be much cheaper than Amazon and the other big tech companies. They start at just $7 per month per terabyte, or just over £8 per month in the UK, so their pricing works out a bit more expensive than Backblaze, but it's not majorly so. It is, however, worth knowing that Wasabi have a minimum storage policy. You must store each file there for at least 90 days, otherwise they can charge you extra, which is a bit odd. And you could get caught out with this if you uploaded loads of video files, rename them locally, and then sync them all in a way that deletes the old files and re-uploads them as new files. So that's worth knowing. The final option I explored was Hetzner, who are a well-known European hosting company that offer useful storage boxes. They don't offer less than 1 terabyte of storage, and they don't also have a 2 terabyte plan. It's 1 terabyte or 5 terabytes, but their prices are good. They're the cheapest option for all price points, other than using the Microsoft Family Plan hack for 5 terabytes, I guess. The neat thing with Hetzner is that it's just simple. You get a simple login and then you can start uploading files. But if you prefer, you can also create sub-accounts and automated snapshots and things like that too. They support a range of different sync technologies as well. The main downside though is that they only have server locations in Finland and Germany, which is good if you're a Eurovision fan, but bandwidth speeds for American customers, for example, might actually be a bit slower than you're used to. To be honest, I'm not really a fan of the cloud. Yes, it has introduced some cool technologies, but it can also make things so much more complex. For my particular needs, which are basically just to have a simple offsite backup for my media files, I don't actually need complicated cloud systems with 10-minute retrieval policies or 90-day minimum storage rules. So I end up signing up with a 5 terabyte Hetzner plan, and so far it seems pretty good. Upload speeds are fairly fast for me, and I like that by default it's all fairly simple, but I can still have sub-accounts to create more buckets if needed. The main downside is the snapshots do count towards your usage limit, which isn't completely surprising, of course, but with Synology C2, for example, they don't actually count towards your limit, so you do have to weigh this up a bit when actually considering the prices. So, once I'm done setting up my new amazing media workflow, what I'll have is 6 PoE cameras recording to my Synology NAS, which is also where our personal files are stored. These personal files, which are around 300 gig, will continue to be backed up with Synology C2, but one of the cheaper plans. I'll then build a Homelab NAS for all of my media files, mounting this as a network drive on my workstation PC when I come to do video editing. Finally, the whole Homelab server will be backed up to my new Hetzner backup storage location. I discussed this new approach more in another video if you want to check that out, but I'd also be interested to hear your thoughts on this and also how you back up your files, so please drop me a comment and let us all know, especially if I'm doing something really stupid that I haven't thought of. I hope you found this video useful though. If you did, please click the thumbs up button. Please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.